at your party, I'm with the gang, and it's gonna be a robbery. So tuck your chain, I'm a killer, girl, I'm sorry, but I can't change. We ain't aiming for your body, shots hit your brain. We come from poverty, man, we ain't have a thing. It's a lot of animosity, but they won't say my name. Them killers rock with me, little nigga, don't get banged.
Damn, Neo, F-A-N-M-I-O.
She don't like
that
body left
with your favorite artist or athlete.
Blowing up my phone, cause she just see me with my new bae. Heartbreaker ladies love me like I'm Cool J. She was trying to cling on to a nigga, but it's too late. But the flight
Erica
to
Ford, who is Erica Ford?
And every single dollar in these bands got a blue face. Diamonds in the rollie, they in HD like it's Blu-ray. The way that I've been balling should make the cover a 2K. Show out for the summer, I might pull up in a new rave. This is the gang that's gonna only get you.
I'm much trying to box
it down, better tighten up your shoelace. Look, go get up close and let the Glock 22 spray. We pop out at your party, I'm with the gang, and it's gonna be a robbery. So tuck your chain, I'm a killer, girl, I'm sorry, but I can't change. We ain't aiming for your body.
The biggest in the game.
Them killers rock with me, little nigga, don't get banged. Cause they'll do that job for me while I hop on the plane.
Yeah, I call a bro, he said he ready for the state. What you claim? You a lame, you ain't never put a game. Why be around some killers that go crazy for the game? If I showed you all my charges, you won't look at me the same. Made some choices in my life I wish I never had to make. Lost my brother, seen him die, and I just seen him glad his way. Got that 40 on my side, and I'm just rolling past his things. But my hands can do the job, and I ain't talking masturbate. I was in and out of states, cause I had a bag to make. I risked my life with this eye, cause God ain't let me pass away. Fuck tomorrow, spin the block. I just know we coming back today. I call Polo, he come Dolo, we get him the fast
way. We pop out at your party, I'm with the gang, and it's gonna be a robbery. So tuck your chain, I'm a killer, girl, I'm sorry, but I can't change. We ain't aiming for your body.
Executive producer Azariah Milan Cartagena is still ghost, but we love her to death. Shout out to Rich Player the God. Shout out to Relish, who's my brother, also my stylist. So if you see that drip, 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 9 times out of 10, it's to Relish. So if y'all want that fuego, go hit him up. It's the biggest show in the game. Don't act stupid. Ciroc, a much finer vodka. Yeah, that's right. Killing them out there with them outfits, man. I've just been Hermesing them to death. And so what happens is, one of the strategies to be, well, at least for me being successful and Khaled being successful, is we always imagine a competition. It really isn't even a competition. So I think about the bums, the dudes I had beef with back in the days, the suckers, the haters. And so that motivates me. That gives me like gas, like fuel to go further in doing whatever I want to do and take it to another level. So, you know, when you see me and I'm clean and I'm dipped fresh and I got some new canary diamonds on or some new, I'm just like, yeah, I'm giving it to them. Now, you know I'm talking to you, suckers. You know who I'm talking to. Once again, rest in peace to my brother Kenny Hill. I was with his son Ryan today and the whole family, brother Pete. Y'all know how I feel about Kenny. Y'all saw me post yesterday about him. What a beautiful guy. Six Nation, Ontario, Canada. An amazing guy, you know. And yeah, so we look at everything. It's competition. So, you know, when I give you that Hermes, it's cool. Like, you could get it. Like, I ain't the only person could get it. But if you got it, then that means you got it. Does that make sense? So Donald Trump's last day, papacito. El Donald is out of here. El Donald is long gone. They moving the furniture. They taking this furniture out the shit. DJ Juanito, what's good? What does this mean? I mean, this guy, he fought in WrestleMania. How the fuck y'all pick him as a president? He was in WrestleMania. And so y'all did that. Some of you guys did that. And as if he couldn't fuck it up enough, he got impeached. He went and got double impeached. He broke a record for impeachment. And found a way to fuck his whole shit up on another level. And so his legacy, whatever it was, or, you know, now they signing a petition, he can't even have a bridge or a school name after him. I'm sure no matter what all the fuckery Donald Trump is into, he didn't imagine it would end like this. And so, his last day. And with all the shit I talk about Donald Trump, all the fuckery, I'm hoping he pardons Kodak Black. I'm hoping he pardons Little Tucci. So, you know, us in the hood, we got like a hypocrite to us. Some things we can't say. Like you know, things you could say, right? Say this was the Dave Chappelle show. Things you could get away with, things you could say. Fuck Donald Trump. Great. Everybody, you know. Things you can't say, damn, Donald Trump did his thing, man. He parted Tucci and Kodak Black. Things you can't say. It's the truth. You know we got a hypocrite code in the hood. You know, shit. We got a hypocrite code. My Knicks are winning. Winning. And so I don't know if you saw that OnlyFans. Y'all better subscribe now. Me and Khaled, we're going to set it off. This is a motivational thing. Me and Khaled, the odd couple. Because Khaled is peace and I'm peace, but with a twist of, And he's like, God, the light, please. May the Lord, you know, and I'm like, may the Lord with a, take that. You out of here, Chef Melissa? God bless you, Chef Melissa. I'll give you the, take that. And so we're going to play this rematch. And let me tell you something. That basketball that you saw that went, that basketball game when I played Khaled and Turks, he's a fraud. Ivan Berrios, his guy, are liars. They edit that video to look like he beat me. That is not the case. And so I keep telling them, I'm going to punish you, Khaled. I'm going to punish you. I don't care if you DJ Khaled, you my brother. I don't care what they talking about. I'm going to pun your head top. And so we play in a couple of days. We got the Miami Heat Arena. We're going to play on that wood floor. And I'm going to show them who's boss. And I'm not taking it easy with him. Fan love. Oh, Khaled, a nice guy. He's just, no. I'm not going for that. And so if you the fan love and all that, don't tune into this because he's going to get it. And I'm too competitive. You know, it's my brother. Real brother. And I'm going to have to take him to the rucker like Eric Leone said. I'm going to have to give him the business. You know what I'm saying? And yo, Dre's going to be the ref, Eric. And I'm going to have to give him the business. This ain't for play, baby. This ain't for play. And I need y'all to repost that little video clip of me and him playing. so everybody could tune in, so they could finally know what it is. Yo, he said, yo, sir said, this ain't the fellowship. No, it ain't. No, it ain't. And what's crazy is they hear me talking that shit. They know I'm coming. They know I'm coming.
Hey, yo.
It's almost there. So it's connecting, but I don't see you.
Marcia.
Should we try again? Why don't you come in the comments? Comment in the comment, and I could take you that way. Of course. All right, just say, yo, I'm here. So every night, we the biggest in the game. And we don't stop. There's no way to bottle us in. We the OGs, we the youth, we the politics, we the everything. We the voice of the hip-hop culture. With no agenda. All right, I got you now. I just can't see you, man.
Dang, man. We can't have, man.
Yo, Polo G, what's up, baby?
Shit, chilling out here in Cali.
Oh, you definitely somewhere in the West Coast, because I'm in Miami and it's dark as hell out here. You got two more hours of that sun, huh?
Probably just an hour, a few more minutes, really.
Sheesh. My brother, welcome to the big show. You moved out to Cali or you still in Chi-Town?
I've been moved out of Chicago, like, right after I signed the deal. I've been in Cali for two and a half years.
So you love it out there?
Hell yeah, it's, like, peaceful, you know? I like to be somewhere where I could be bored.
Where you could be bored?
Yeah, for sure.
I mean, it's same for me. I moved to Miami.
Yo.
So I moved to Miami maybe like 18, 19 years ago, and coming out of New York, everybody was like, yo, what the fuck you doing, Joe? And I like that nobody really know me, they can't bother me. So mm-hmm. If I see somebody here, I'll say peace and show them love, but keep it moving. They don't really, really know my mother, my aunt. When I'm in New York, they stop me and be like, how's your brother? And you know, I gotta really talk to these people or I'm full of shit.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? So I get what you're saying.
For sure.
And so how's it been for you, man? You've been rocking. How long you been out? Like about 3-4 years?
Yeah, shit. Not even that long. Shit. My biggest song, Pop Out, shit, that shit been rocking for about, it just hit 2 years a few days ago. I really go off that. I dropped my first album, a year and a half ago, so I really just really been cemented in the game for about 2 years.
Yeah, man. And how's it, you know, well, you out of Chi, and Chi is a very dangerous place. And then for a guy like you that's winning like that, like, so I was like, now I see you in LA, you chilling, cruise control, you know, this Chi, man, it's an uncontrollable, I love Chi-Town, man. It's somewhere I love to go all the time. And is things calming down or is it still on and popping?
Shit, it done got worse. I think the year that just passed was like the worst year in a nice amount of years. So shit, like really taking a turn for the worse. I feel like though the pandemic play a big part in that though.
People need money. People got to go out there and get their shit like that.
And it just been so much going on.
And you know, I said, and social media definitely plays a major part in that shit too. You know what I'm saying? Because before a motherfucker diss you on the block, it's just you and a couple of dudes that was out there. Now a motherfucker diss you prime time. It's like, damn, now we got to go there.
Uh-huh. For sure. Social media been playing a big part in it ever since that just became a thing. now we living in the era and day and age where back then the streets was just the streets, but this day and age, social media tied into the streets where the shit damn near go hand in hand when it shouldn't.
That is a fact. That is a fact. Like, it shouldn't be, you shouldn't be involved in that social media. You telling on yourself, bro. It's just, it's no way around it. And the thing I never understood, right, and we get back to the positive, but, you know, every time I go to Chicago, especially in the winter, shit like 20 below zero. And I'm like, how the fuck they find time to catch a motherfucker in 20 below zero?
Yeah, nigga done figured that shit out, figured out the science to that shit. They really done adapted to their climate. So this shit, it don't matter the weather. When you serious about what you doing, you can figure out a way.
I get what you're saying. Coming up in the shot, who are some influences? Because the shot is like a major player in the rap scene, in the R&B scene. Like, coming up in the shot, like, what was it, Kanye? Who was it that inspired you out the shot?
To be totally honest, like, I got a lot of love for Kanye. I fuck with Kanye. I fuck with anything Chicago, period. Anybody, any artist coming out of Chicago, I got nothing but love for them. But as far as something that played into an influence for me, it was more so underground, drill rap, the younger rappers who was coming up in the era of Chief Keef, like Dirt, Herb, Bibby. Them was more like inspirations to me because they were so much more closer to my age doing their thing and talking about shit that I was going through too.
That boy Chief Keef, boy. That boy put it down for real.
For sure. He definitely started a whole nother generation of culture, for real.
That energy, that youth, that real nigga shit. That boy Chief Keef, man, nah, he's a special one.
I agree.
He definitely a special one. So when you see stuff like the movie Shot, the TV show on TV, does that represent like the Shot, like the true Shot, or is it just Hollywood shit?
I mean, I've never really watched that show like that, so I can't get my opinion for real, to be totally honest.
That's smart. Nah, it's smart, you know, because what I learned was, I was watching a young dude, I don't know what his name was, but he was doing an interview, and I watched somebody do an interview with him. I was trying to ask him all these questions about all these other artists. He was like, yo, check this out. I'm here to talk about my album, and you people be trying to get us to talk bad about other artists. Then we wind up having real beef with them, and you know, y'all got some clickbait, some shit. I ain't with that. And I've been in the game 25 years. When I seen that, I learned that from them. I was like, yo, they've been doing this shit to me for 20 years.
For sure. They'll definitely sneak that in.
And then rest in peace, Juice WRLD. I saw you got to work with Juice WRLD. I met him a couple of times. He's a beautiful guy, man. Tell us how y'all connected. You know,
we both from the Juice WRLD. You know, he like different type of dude, real selfless person, real humble. At the time, Juice WRLD reached out to me and connected with me. I was still making my come up and making my rounds, making my name. And he was, to me, one of the biggest artists like in the world at the time, you know. And he reached out to me and just showed love, just basically telling me like, I fuck with my music and shit like that. And the shit had meant a lot to me knowing that he from the city and he doing his thing too. So we linked up, I think, in Miami. It was Rolling Loud time. And ever since then, we just was like this.
Man, let me tell you, man, Rolling Loud, for us, it was Summer Jam. When we was coming up, it was like, yo, you get on Summer Jam. But right now, for the youth, it's definitely Rolling Loud, right?
For sure.
And that shit go on all day. So it's crazy for me because I did a couple of Rolling Louds, and You know, I'm up in there. They got 100 artists back there and shit. Everybody, they did one in New York, bro. You would think Bin Laden was coming, man. They had so many metal detectors, 100 million cops, 100, like, I mean, is it, does it pop off at Rolling Loud, or is it like they just anticipating shit?
I mean, in a place like New York, I could see why they had like big on the security, but as far as like how Rolling Loud be, it's always a foreign experience. Everything always goes smooth from what I see. Like, it's always just artists coming out, do their thing. The fans enjoy it, and it's just rap from there. But I could see, though, like, in a place like New York, why they'd be so high security.
Yeah, I see you linked up with TJ.
Yeah.
And TJ, when I met TJ for the first time, I was in a jail talking to the inmates, like telling them, y'all, change your life, come on. And then the next thing I know, I'm behind Rolling Loud somewhere, and TJ comes up to me, he's like, yo, you remember I seen you on Rikers Island, and you was telling us to chill and change, and then at this time, he was little TJ,
yeah,
with a hit record.
Yeah.
You know, how did y'all connect on that song right there, which is your biggest song, right?
Yeah, that's the biggest song I ever dropped for now. But two young dudes, we both on the same label, so that's really a big part on what put to it. And we had just linked up in the stew. Our A&Rs connected us, and we was just rocking with each other in general because we was both young from our cities doing our thing. He was like 17 or 16 at the time. I was like 19.
And it all panned out, huh? So what's in the future? What's in the future for Polo G? Like, what do you see in the future? Music, besides music, do you got your mind on other business?
I definitely, in the future, I definitely plan to be more big business savvy. Like just honing in on my investments, being far along in my investments outside of rap, you know. And as far as music, I just know for 1,000% fact that in the near future and down the road, I'm going to show a lot of longevity as an artist, and I feel like I'm going to be one of the biggest artists in the game. I'm getting that now, but I'm saying, like, I'm going to be really cemented as one of the biggest artists in the game, and one of the best, too.
Well, all you got to do is just keep consistent, stay focused, stay out of trouble. You know what I'm saying? And that's always the main thing, because that'll fuck you up in every way, every level. You know what I'm saying? So, you know, I believe you if you say it. Because I used to say it to people back in the day, and they looked at me like I was crazy. And here we are all these years later, still relevant, still consistent, still dropping music or whatever have you. So it's up to you if you're willing to fight for it. I mean, it's never like this. It's always like this. It's always like this. It's never like this. It's always like this. So you up, then you might throw some shit that ain't like that and everybody wanna sleep, and then you throw some shit like that, then you might throw some shit like that, and then, you know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
And I can't lie to you, that's how I got to see who is really with me. Cause you know, in this industry, everybody, yes man, everybody act like, you know, they love you and you the shit. When you got a hit, everybody, and the minute you get cool, they act like you got AIDS or some shit or COVID. They stay away from you like, nah, nah, nah. For me, I was lucky because I had shit like this, shit like this, shit like this, shit like, so I really learned who was with me in the industry. And I was like, oh shit, that's how it go? Like, yeah. That's how these motherfuckers is? And so, but it's better than somebody who just go like this all the time because they never really know who's with them.
Yeah, Nate, you feel me? You ain't got no mistakes to learn from, for real. You got to bump your head.
All right, my brother, when we going to hear some new music from you?
Man, I got some shit. All this first quarter of the year, I'm finna be dropping shit. I'm definitely finna flood the streets. I'm definitely finna flood my fans with new music. So I got some shit coming, you feel me, within these next few months.
Let me ask you another question. Your top five dead or alive artists ever.
My top five. This personal preference right here. My top five. I was had to say. I gotta throw Pac in there. I gotta throw Wayne in there. That's one of my all-time favorites.
Woo!
Damn. I'm not really a top five guy, I'm not gonna lie.
I know you're not a top five, but you got two, man. You're almost there. You got three more. Three more to, you know, who influenced you. You know what I'm saying?
You said influence or just top five?
Nah, I'm saying top five, man. I'm saying fuck. Although I'm saying top five, man.
If I'm giving my honest opinion, I say Pac. I say Wayne. You gotta throw Kendrick in there to me.
That's right. Whoever you want,
Kendrick
is,
in there.
He is that caliber.
I would have to say, Jay. And for the fifth one, who would I say? Damn, I have to say Jay for the fifth one.
No, you said Jay for the fourth.
No, I'm saying for the fifth one, who I'm trying to. Because there's a lot of artists.
I know, man. I know. But you, I'm going to help you out and say, do you want to throw a Chi-Town joint?
I don't know. I fuck with the city shit, but I'm trying to see what artists. I mean, I don't want to be cliche and say Big.
Don't be cliche. You can say Big because he's in my top five, but that's your top five. You got Pop, you got Wayne, you got Kendrick, you got Jay. This a mean four, I'll tell you that much. But God,
I ain't gonna lie, you want me to be totally honest? I wouldn't say top five. All-time MC, like, it's just far as just straight pen game or spin game, but I'm just saying as an overall artist, I'll put Drake in there because he did.
That's it. I knew you wanted to put Drake there, man. I knew that shit, man. Ain't nothing wrong with saying Drake. Drake, one of my favorite artists of all time. People debate is he's the best one ever created.
For sure.
Like, I mean, like, Drake is in the top five. I mean, if you had a starting five, Pop, Wayne, Kendrick, Jay, Drake. You ain't say nothing whack here, man. That shit mean. That's a mean five. That's a mean five. Right there. Yo, my brother, you be safe. God bless you, man. Stay focused, man, and I hope to see you in person one day soon.
For sure. Appreciate you having me.
Thank you, my brother. Thank you for being on The Biggest. Thank you. You don't know who I know. It's the biggest show in the game, man. It's the big, 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 big show. Every day. Weekdays. Tomorrow night, Amber Rose. Amber Rose tomorrow night, 8 p.m. Eastern. Every day. This shit lit. Nothing you could do about it. Polo G. You don't know who I know. You don't know who I know. And so the man is focused. And he's doing his thing. Staying sucker free. On Revolt TV. Every Tuesday, 10 p.m. We've had everybody you could think of on this show. Kalani, Sweetie, Alicia Keys, Mary J. Blige, Floyd Mayweather, Mike Tyson, Bun B, Killer Mike. Whoever you name has been on this show. Lil CJ was on the other day. Hoopty. It's the biggest in the game, man. And so Lil Wayne, we're praying that God gets the pardon. Now, I don't fuck with Donald Trump. Y'all know that. But I'm hoping Kodak and Lil Wayne get that pardon. And so I'm never going to like them, but I might be like, you know, I'm never going to fuck with Donald Trump, but I might be like, he let my brothers go. And so the game is crazy. The COVID is real. The COVID too real. So yesterday I shot a video, me, Khaled, Diddy, y'all Ivan Barrios, you on the big, big shot. The video's coming out amazing. When can we get it? I'm dropping a single tomorrow, the soundtrack for the Big Big Show. Amazing, produced by Kool & Drake. Khaled's on there. Did the Rihanna vocals get in here? Did the Rihanna vocals? And so, shout out to DJ Amorphous. And yeah. And so I thought I retired from music. Last album, Family Ties. And so I thought I retired. And Dre's like, yo, we need a soundtrack for the Big Big Show. And so he gassed me, and I start working on this shit. It's what I call like COVID-19 music. Shit, the light. The single tomorrow is called Sunshine, aka The Light. It's just a vibe. When you hear it, you're going to be like this. And so tomorrow, with Kamala Harris, Joe Biden take over, and the Wicked Witch of the West is out the White House. You're going to have some good music to be like. Cousin Miriam was good. And so it's a vibe, AKA a very big vibe. And that'll be out tomorrow. We shot a video yesterday. Shit was so fire. We shot it in this mansion that floats in the water. So it's a mansion. We in Miami, it floats in the water. The house is floating, guys. Tone Sunshine, I love you, Tone, for life. You know, I know Tone Sunshine. So he was a kid, a teenager. And so I turned around and said, so Tone came to the video yesterday. He had a silk shit on. He was looking good. And we had the best time in the world. And somebody had asked me, yo, what's up with Tone Sunshine? Like, what is he doing in the video? And I said, well, what do you mean, what is he doing in the video? And they was like, no, you know, I was like, it's my fucking brother. Fuck a video. Fuck anybody who got something to say. See, in this crew, when you're loyal, you always get rewarded. Loyalty is everything to me. That's my brother. I love Tone Sunshine. And guess what? He brings this light. You ever had a little brother that makes you laugh and have fun? And this is my brother. And so it's good to see It says a lot about what we got. It says a lot about our character. When you see brothers together for 20 something years, it says a lot about you. When you can't keep it together like that, you at full feed. And so when you see me and I got the same dudes around me, and you got Khaled with me, who's been with me 25 years plus, and Dre, and Tone Sunshine, and Diddy. Man, loyalty is royalty, bro. And we have a great time, man. And so we did the video. We everybody got tested for COVID. Everybody got tested for COVID. It's part of the budget. Ivan Berrios. Serge, what's up, my brother? And so everybody was getting tested. They poke the thing like diabetes, and then they see if you got the shit. And so nobody got to be in there but Khaled. And I'm nervous, but he's really nervous. So he in his car, he's like, yo, Joe, what's going on in there? I'm like, yo, Khaled, he played security the whole time. He'd be like, yo, you see the guy with the black? He ain't trying to go to the COVID test. Like, yo, my man. So Khaled's outside catching motherfuckers trying to go through without doing the COVID test. Yo, the girl in the purple, she ain't really, I ain't see her at the table. Yo, get the girl with the purple. And so this guy's hilarious. So we about to shoot his scene. It's a scene with him and Puffy and me. And they had like a dance off. I don't want to tell you the whole video. And shout out to Ghazi Empire, Nima. And so before Khaled walks in there, mind you, I've been there for 7 hours. Two guys come and start spraying sanitation. What the fuck you call that, man? The sanitizer, like, what they call it when they spray the shit. And you know what I mean. You know, sanitizer, whatever. They got these guns to spray the shit, like if, you know, you spraying for bugs or some shit. The camera crew is there, people that own the fucking floating yacht, the extras, and I'm like, yo, but what the fuck? And they're like, yo, the man got the fog machine, but with the to get the COVID out, and it's outdoor, smoke sanitizer. Yo, Tom, this nigga crazy. Oh shit. And I'm saying, yo, the COVID spray, man. And I'm like, yo, this is crazy. In the middle of the video, they shooting this shit up. And I'm like, and then he come, he got the mask up here though. Like to the one eye of the pink. And I'm like, yo, bro, like relax, we outside. And he had the tank, nigga. He was like, yo. And so, but I get it. COVID too real. We got to be responsible. We got to be responsible. We got to be, you know, you got to think about it, because a lot of people feel like they can't catch it because they're young or whatever. They can get over it quick. And I keep meeting people and they be like, yeah, I had it already. And those are guys that you see with no mask on. They're like, hey, I had it already. No problem. You're like, damn, they had it already. You know what I'm saying? And so we, thank God, are the last of the Mohicans running around with the mask, acting like, you know what I'm saying? Fooning yup, watching that COVID. But you know, there's people out here that's like, yo, they feel like they had it already and they don't care. Shout out Pristine Jewelers. My guys definitely don't feel like they can catch that thing, because they had it already. And so I turn around. Shout out to Polo G for being on this thing right here. I turn around. So we had a great, great time. So Mom dropping the record. It's a feel-good record. Shout out to everybody involved with the record. Right? So it's a great time. Inspired by DJ Amorphis. So this young kid, he's a DJ, he's killing shit, and he inspired the new track. And so I had to hit him up and be like, yo, Amorphis, you know what? I want to give you credit for inspiration. I want you in the video. I want to put featuring DJ Amorphis because you did inspire this. No, I've never been down with a gang, guys. Never. I've never been down with a gang. Ever. You know what I'm saying? So, he came to the video. We had a great time. You know what I'm saying? He came to the video. We had a great time. Oh, there you go. There you go. I seen somebody write some shit to me. He said, yo, Fat Joe, you don't care about the fans. I just clicked them. Was about to jump them on. He backed out. And because I'm about that life, even though it's about the light. And so, you know, he came through. We had fun with him. He DJ'd, said, we showed him love. But that's what it's about, man. It's about inspiring the next generation. 50 Cent, right? Somebody said you're getting 50 in here. You know, I had dinner with my brother 50 Cent the other day. And I'm going to tell you what he told me in my ear. And I said, yo, 50, man. Like, you hit me up all the time. I hit you up. We have dinner. Like, when the fuck you coming on the big biggest show in the game? He looks at me like I'm crazy. He said, Joe, man, the show's amazing. I watch it all the time. You're one of the greatest storytellers. When niggas hear you talk, they feel like they dead. He was bigging me up crazy, right? But he told me something I didn't understand at the time when he told me, but when I went back to my house later that day, I thought about it. I said, man, this guy might be right. Because he was like, pretty much he was telling me, yo, I got beef with a lot of your friends, and I don't know how to sugarcoat it. So be careful what you wish for, in other words, is, can we get him on here? Oh, shit, 50 Cent, Fat Joe, you know it's lit. And then he gets to talking shit about people I love. So I don't want that. I definitely don't want that. And so basically he was trying to tell me that that's where it's going to go. And so I can't sugarcoat it. You know what, my brother? I love you. Peace to the gods. BMF started shooting today. That's going to be big. That BMF series, The Raising Cane. Y'all know I play that 50 new song on there. It's one of my favorite songs. Like, really one of my favorite songs out right now. But to come on here and we talking about and then get to talk that shit about my... That ain't the platform. You know, we're about the light. We're about the love, the light, you know. And so the OnlyFans, me and Khaled, we're gonna start it off with the basketball game, and we're gonna do this shit for real. Stephen A. Smith commentating. We in the Miami Heat Arena. This shit gonna be real. I got my outfit for when I walk in the tunnel. You know when you see just before the biggest game, Greek the Freak or Kobe or Rest in Peace or D-Wade come in with the outfit, Russell Westbrook? Yeah. Yeah, I got one of them outfits to walk up in that motherfucker like that. Know what I'm saying? And when they be in the office, enter in the arena, and I'm wearing some shit, maybe a Louis Vuitton NBA bag, some fly shit. And then they cut to the thing, they're gonna see me stretching and getting ready for this man, you know? And I realize a major key is years ago, I was bigger than Callan. So I used to muscle him and back him down. And I'm realizing this motherfucker bigger than me. So it's like, I don't know if that muscle, I gotta switch up and he said he'd been watching the tape. This guy's fab. Yo, Cal is the best guy in the world. Don't get it fucked up. But this guy's fab. He said, man, I've been watching the tape. Your knees ain't the same. Your knees ain't the same. He said, years ago, I couldn't spin. I couldn't do this to you. You ain't the same. I'm like, motherfucker, this disrespectful. And I'm like, all right, I got to show you. And I'm not, I swear to y'all, this is real. This ain't no bullshit. And I keep telling him so he could know, because I'm not going to just play around and, yo, Khaled, no, I'm not. I'm not going to play with this man. Yo, Khaled.
Yo.
So I'm telling them, the OnlyFans, we got a game coming up. It's a rematch. You and Ivan cheated and edited the video. You edited the video to look like you beat me, man.
Listen, guys, let me explain something to you. You know what I love about, if you watch the video, you hear me hitting the ball. It's all ball. You hear that sound. You don't hear no skin. You don't see no bruises on his arm. Nothing like that.
No. Hurt.
Of course it's going to hurt.
No, you was beating me up.
Listen, let's be clear. It's my brother's family. So, you know, we're going to use the words, you know, beautifully. Not only did I beat him in basketball, I'm going to beat him again. The good thing is that when I win, he wins. When he wins, I win. So that's what's so beautiful about brotherhood and family.
I'm not doing it.
So all you got to do is go to link in my bio or link in Joe's bio right here. This is the new pay-per-view. This is the new pay-per-view. And after we do this basketball game, you know, we're going to continue giving you the light, cloth talk. You know what I'm saying? We're gonna continue to motivate and inspire. But the game, first of all, I don't know if you know. Listen, everybody gonna wanna play basketball.
Tell them about the tank. You told me, I don't know how cool. Let me see the camera for a second. You told me that you've been watching the videotape carefully.
So and then my knees and
say the truth to them. How you talk to me? Because you always
want
to
be honest.
Listen. But you told me my knees ain't the same, man.
Your knees is definitely not the same. I've been playing Joe basketball. First of all, me and Joe used to play basketball together for years on the same team. So when I played him in Turks and Caicos, I noticed that the knees ain't the same like they were 10, 15, 20 years ago. So I can get around a little better. But I am a little, was I bigger then or?
No, you were smaller than.
I was smaller than. So
I've been watching the tape. And I said, years ago, I was able to back you down because I was bigger than you.
Yeah.
Right?
Yo, Fat Joe was Fat Joe back in them days.
So what I'm saying is I'm watching the tape and I say, yo, you know what? I ain't been finessing you right. 2021.
So listen to this. Today I asked him because he knows we about to play the game. And again, go to link in the bio and Joe's bio or my bio and sign up now to watch this game. Not only to watch the game, you're going to get continued motivation. Success. It's going to be incredible. But listen, I asked him today, Joe, I'm going to play you one-on-one. I really don't like playing basketball one-on-one. I don't like it. It's too much work. Now, I offered to play him the three-point line shootout, three-point shots. He don't want to do it.
Because I watch you take 100,000 from French Montana.
I beat French Montana every single time.
Yeah, but I'm not playing that.
And
I'm not playing that game.
And there's a list of people. There's a list.
Who else you beat?
Listen, the reason why I don't want to name everybody is because I don't want people to think that we're going to be playing basketball all the time on our channel.
No, we're not.
We're doing this
That's how we're kicking it off.
This is a rematch.
So we played the game, and everybody keep asking us in our DMs and all over, yo, when y'all going to play again? So we just don't, we got to only
But if the bag is involved, and, you know, I am, you know, not one-on-one. The three-point shot, like somebody, you know what I'm saying?
But one-on-one, these knees going to work.
Listen, I'm going to play him one-on-one. I'm going to beat him again, another one. But what I was trying to tell him, because I hear him talk about his knees, I'm willing to play him a three-point shootout.
No.
You don't want that.
No. You got to run with me. You got to run.
And I'm beating him in the one-on-one.
You got to run with me. We got to sweat.
Yo, but hold on, Joe. Joe got this record. You seen the pictures. Don't act like you don't see the pictures. Stop. You seen the pictures. He got a record. Yo, Joe, let's talk to the director.
Talk to Ivan. He came on the comments. He's supposed to be editing, right?
He's not going to give you a glimpse. He gave me a glimpse. You got one.
Like a movie?
Nah, like a movie. The way you was walking. I'm not going to give him everything. No, you got one. Yo, listen. So Joe got another record. Let's keep it honest. Joe always got a record. Don't forget, this is the guy that gave you We Thuggin' All the Way Up. Hold on. This is the director. The director's calling right now. Ivan Berrios directing the video.
Yo, Ivan, how's that video coming out? He loves this shit. Yo, Ivan.
Yo, you love this shit. I realize this, man. Yo, you love this shit, man.
Yeah, he love it. Yo, how's the video?
Are we giving a little preview or no? No preview?
Oh, shit. Let me see a little preview for the people.
5 seconds, though. Only 5 seconds. Because we got to give it.
Oh, shit. Right, we getting a preview?
Hold on.
You going from the beginning? Hold on. Before you push play, you going to the beginning or like in the middle?
I'm going more towards like all right. 30 seconds.
All right, go ahead.
I'll go right here. You guys
can't
ready?
See it.
Go ahead.
Then that's that riding game. That's the volume, Utopia volume, 4.
All right, ready?
Are you going off the Utopia?
It's 2021. It's time to bring the light in. You're going to bring the light in, you know? DJ Khaled, I see you. Cool and Dre, I see you. Machine Cubans in the building.
Swiss Beats on the check-in. Silk on that motherfucker.
Hold on.
That's all
too
that
much.
Black on liquor.
Oh, it's too much. Hold on.
All that black on liquor. You see all that?
Listen, he got a record, man. Let me explain about that. Hold on.
More fire.
I don't listen. You got to give me the floor on this one.
All right. Yeah.
So the light. You know what I'm saying? You know it's important for us to bring the light, and the light come in different ways. The light come in music, the light come from weather, the light come from energy, the light come from family, friends. Obviously, God is the light because God is love and the light is love. But sometimes there's no light and we have to bring the light and we have to be the light. I know you heard me say this before and I'm going to keep telling you. The reason why I'm telling you is because you know, we all been going through some hard times, and I'm not talking about, you know, this pandemic, you know, it's been a year. And it's the times are different. But what I do know is you have to be the light even when the times are different and the times are dark. So we have to be the light. Now, since I got that across, musically, Joe has the record. And when he played it for me, when he was making it, I'm like, this is the light. And this is important to come out now. Usually we make records, we plan, and we figure out when we want to put it out. But I'm like, yo, Joe, put this out as soon as you can. And Joe will explain when he premieres it, because he got an old surprise for y'all. But the music is the light. It make you feel good. You see the sunshine. You hear it. And, you know, not only are we going to embrace this light, it's just really necessary and very urgent that we need this at a time like this. So when this record comes out, I'm hoping it inspires not only just the people, but also everybody in the music business, because we need an energy to bring the world together with this energy of the light. And I'm gonna be the light. You know what I'm saying? I want you to be the light too. You know what I'm saying? You know, Joe called me now, like, yo, if I just say we went away from the light for 1 second, our job is to go the light. To bring us back to the light, because
yeah.
It's so easy to get discouraged and somebody will try to take you away from the light. So we have to be the light. So Joe got a record out and he's about to drop a video with it, and it's part of the light, because the light come in different ways. But Joe, congrats. It's gonna be big, bro. It's gonna be big. It's gonna be big.
See, my brother bigged it up. Legend. Yo, Serge, I see you. And let me tell you, Swiss, I see you. We dropping a joint tomorrow. It's gonna be big. But like he said, it's all about having fun, having a great time. It's all about the light.
Listen, it's about the light. We got, listen, everybody out there, support each other, man. Support each other, man. Like, yo, it's okay to post somebody up and show them love. Mm. It's okay to like somebody. It's okay to shout them out. It's okay to support other people's businesses, because it's ours. You know what I'm saying? Like, it's for us. You know what I'm saying? It's okay. It's okay. It's okay to show love. It's okay. It's you know, it's the cool thing to do. It's called show love. It's called we born with these. Show love. It's okay. I'm just trying to tell you, it's really okay.
It's really okay.
You know what I'm saying?
And so what happens is we always show love. And so my brother Diddy showed up. A couple of friends showed up. And we just had a great time. And we didn't realize that we've been in the house for 10 months to the point of where, man, it felt good to wear some outfits and shoot a vid, right or wrong. Like,
well, look at this outfit right here. Look at this outfit. Look at that silk. Come on. Don't
you
look,
see that sky blue
listen,
shit?
Like I said, it's okay to show love. If you ain't like that picture and you came across that, stop.
That's that Dolce.
Come on, man. Listen, hold on.
Yeah,
hold
on. Yeah. Charlie,
look at this. Look at this. Look how like the light is hitting.
It's sexy.
It's okay. Hold on.
Man,
now let's not get discouraged.
Diddy look like, wow, he's walking.
Let's not get discouraged. Go to the Joe's bio right now.
The OnlyFans.
OnlyFans.
Join that OnlyFans.
The new pay-per-view.
Wow!
You can watch this game. All you got to do is go in the bio. This is the new pay-per-view. This is the new pay-per-view. And let me tell you something. If you think it's just a game, we got some big surprises that day. And let me tell you another thing, too, is I'm never stopping. That's on everything I love. And this guy, he's not stopping.
I like when you talk.
Nah, Joe, you know what's so crazy?
Nah, I love it.
Because, you know, I've been chilling. I ain't telling
you. Just
no, you know, I ain't been saying nothing. Because when I come, and you know, don't act like you don't know.
The light.
Listen, the light.
Yo.
Listen. But Joe, you know,
link in my bio, the OnlyFans.
Uh-oh.
And,
Honey, I'm gonna tell you what happened. Hey.
Daddy, it's too loud.
What?
You're too loud.
Wow. My son said we're too loud. I love you.
I love you
so much, boy. I do everything for you. You know that.
Good night, Daddy.
Good night, Daddy.
You know I love you, right? Say, we the best.
We the best.
You better believe it. So you know who I do it for. On everything I love, I'm never stopping. That's on everything I love. Yo, Joe, now that's the Joker. That's the Joker moment.
Listen, guys.
Say that video.
My nephew aside, we the biggest in the game. He said we too loud. We're making too much noise. That game coming soon, and not just game, we're giving you game. We're giving you motivation. We're bringing the light. We're showing you. Go on that OnlyFans, me and Khaled together. It's almost like an odd couple. You see how this is. We love each other. We connected. But he's such positive, and you know me, I'm with the take that. So, we got that shit going on. Polo G already came on, my brother. He was on here. He ran it up, had like 22,000 people on there at one time. It's the biggest show in the game. Tomorrow night, Amber Rose. We got a lot to talk about. Put God first, believe in God. Have faith in good times and bad times. Always trust in God, for God is the light. See you tomorrow, the biggest.